This is Ryan Gorsey, publisher of BearTerritory.net for Scout.com here at California Memorial Stadium with Mike Vernon of the San Francisco Chronicle for our weekly three and out. We finally have a game this week, and it's going to be against the Arizona Wildcats in Tucson on Saturday. So for three and out, the first thing we're going to talk about, I know it sounds like we're a broken record, Luke Rubenzer. He's certainly become one of the darlings of the media, even though we can't talk to him, but certainly one of the big storylines here for Cal in this season. What did you see out of him, and what do you think the Bears are going to be able to work with Rubenzer on Saturday?
Well, boy, I mean, he looked sharp today. He was throwing the ball well.
And running.
And running, of course. And what I want to talk about is we've seen him run. I think it's about time we see him pass. I think they're going to run him early, and then I wouldn't be shocked to see him start throwing the ball, try to catch the Arizona defense off guard. I'm guessing they're going to prepare for him running. I don't know how much they know about him throwing.
Well, Cody Fajardo was a very much a running quarterback as well. They faced him against Nevada, and you know the I believe Nevada ran for over 200 yards the week before, and they ran for just barely over 100. Fajardo, sure, the week before had ran for over 100 by himself, and they changed when they realized that Arizona has a fairly stout run defense, and the passing defense is a bit suspect.
That's what it looks like. I mean, that if there's one thing to attack on this Arizona defense, it's through the air. It's those defensive backs. And, well, sure enough, that works out pretty well for Cal, don't you think?
Absolutely. And you know what? The next, that kind of dovetails nicely into the next thing I want to talk about, which is that Arizona passing defense, which is 10th in the league. Rushing defense, 3rd in the league. Granted, it's only after three games, but you'd have to think that Cal's passing offense, with the bevy of wide receivers that they have, with as deep as that position is going to take advantage.
Yeah, I think so. I mean, that's what Cal does well. They throw the ball. They've got big receivers who can go up and catch the ball. And if the cornerbacks aren't playing well, it's a field day, especially with the quarterback as accurate as Jared Goff. And then when you've got the confusion of Luke Rubenzer, who may be throwing to some open receivers if he does, in fact, throw the ball.
And opponents are passing for over 64% completion, yep, against Arizona. That's really... That's not a good passing defense. Rich Rodriguez has been not very much not over the moon with his entire defensive scheme, as the three games they played have been fairly close, probably closer than I think he would have hoped, particularly against UT San Antonio and Nevada. So we'll see what that's definitely, I think, going to be part of the narrative, is how can Cal attack that defense and really pick it apart, because as much as we talk about Rubenzer as a runner, this offense is predicated on the pass.
It is. And as much as the Cal coaches like to say they've got to run, well, they want to run so they can pass. I mean, so they can pass better. So that'll be the key. Throwing to open receivers, can Jared Goff hit them? He has all year, and I think he will again.
And the back shoulder fade, of course, was working well again today. That's something I know you wanted to talk about. That is a pass that he's added to his repertoire that's been unstoppable.
It's so interesting to me. I mean, Cal has had two or three touchdowns this season, goal line fades, and that's not a very – lots of teams run it, but it's hard to execute. You need a really accurate quarterback, and you need – and it's a big receiver who can get up and catch the ball. Cal has those weapons. Not many colleges do. So they've been running it, and I think they're going to run it some more.
There's no shortage of weapons on the other side of the field for Arizona. Their passing attack certainly very, very sharp. But with Anu Solomon,
yes,
as the quarterback. One thing about Anu Solomon, well, two things really. He has the third highest passing average per game, but he also has one of the worst passer efficiency ratings and one of the worst completion percentages in the league. So you have a guy who's second in the league in touchdown passes, third in yards per game as far as throwing the ball. He makes a lot of boneheaded errors.
Yeah, and you know, we can talk about the stats, and he does make some errors, but he is battle-tested. And for a young guy, those close games, he's remained calm, and I think he's looked all right. I mean, if they're in a close game, it's something he's going to be used to, which makes a difference.
And obviously, he's going to have another weapon. This is kind of a point 3A
oh, yes,
in Nick Wilson. the freshman out of Fresno Central East. Cal wanted him. Cal was on him for quite some time before he wound up committing to the Wildcats and missed the 111 season last year. He's a guy who is very dangerous, who has about half of Arizona's big plays on the ground, just like Anu Solomon has nearly half of their big plays. All of them as far as passing. But Anu Solomon also has three runs of over, I believe, over 15 yards. So that's going to be something that Cal's going to have to prepare for as well, is the Arizona running game. And Solomon, of course, is a part of that, being a mobile quarterback.
The middle of that Cal defense is going to be tested. The ends too, but it's, I think Arizona's really going to test out Cal's defensive tackles in the interior of that defense. We'll see how healthy is Mustafa Jaleel. Can he take a lot of action all game? We'll find out. Austin Clark is undersized. He was out last week. Sore knee. They say he's healthy now. That's two question marks on Cal's defense right up the gut. Look for Arizona to attack that.
But the one thing that I did see today is that the defensive ends, Todd Barr and Brandon Scarlett, were really sealing well off the edge. And that's something that Cal defenses have had a problem with in the past, particularly against teams like Oregon that like to get on the edge.
Sure.
So seeing Brandon Scarlett and Todd Barr really hold those edges and really seal the outside, that's going to limit the amount of times that Nick Wilson's going to be able to bounce outside. Although Nick Wilson is more of a downhill up-the-gut runner who runs with a lot of power. So the entire defensive line, and really the middle linebackers, whoever it is, whether it's Hardy Nickerson or whether it's Michael Barton or whether it's Devontae Downs, is going to see that's going to be a very important part. And Jalen Jefferson, I know, is very excited. No, Hardy Nickerson is very excited to face Nick Wilson.
Oh, he was pumped today. He was saying, you know, it's time we get a test. That's what they pride themselves on. We'll see if they still pride themselves on it come
after
Sunday.
Saturday, yeah. All right, well, I guess instead of three and out, I think we just converted on fourth down. We got 4 points. So, for Michael Vernon of the San Francisco Chronicle, this is Ryan Gorsey, publisher of BearTerritory.net for Scout.com here at California Memorial Stadium. This has been Three and Out. Thanks for playing along. We'll catch you on the flip side. You know.